Errol Spence got into another car accident.
Yeah.
This time he didn't really sustain crazy injuries or anything that. But he pushed his date back. Could we see a situation where we don't get Crawford versus Spence for Undisputed?
Yes. Yes, you can. That accident, granted, he was able to walk away. Thank God. But you don't know what internal injuries that he could have had. Things are hurting. Could have had whiplash. Could have hurt his back. You know, things that you're not seeing, you know, exterior-wise doesn't mean it didn't happen interiorly. So, you know, for him, he's going to have to do what's best for him to make sure his health is in favor. And then everything that, you know, the way that business was gone, the way that the process went with the whole Bud, taking another fight, not really keeping everybody in the loop, it's not great business etiquette. I don't think that works in his favor. But it's going to be, it's becoming more difficult now because the belts are starting to demand for you to defend the belt. So everybody's set aside. We all waited for that Crawford and Spence fight to happen. Now we're past it, so you got to make some either. I most likely see that fight at 54 if it were to happen.
Now Spence has what, three mandatories?
Yeah, he's got what, WBC, WBA,
IBF, and then as and when May comes, Crawford's mandatory will be ordered. So it's the window closed because fans. You know, fans were really, really clamoring for this fight.
Yeah, I think everybody was. Mm. But yeah, I think the window could potentially be closed. I hate to say it so, like, sudden, but it kind of is. This fight should have been made back in the summer. Now we're in the end of December. And, Q1 is... that Q1 is going to put you in a position to have to either defend or move up. So I don't necessarily feel the fight happen unless something crazy happened, like they can make it happen in, you know, March or April. And I don't see it happening that early.
Cool. Thanks, man. I appreciate you.
Appreciate it.